Hello friends, in last lecture we discussed about the temporary adjustments of theodolite. Today we are discussing about the measurements of angle. So first we see the measurement of horizontal angle. So to measure the horizontal angle, there are two methods adopted for the measurement of angle using transit theodolite. First one is direct method and second is repetition method. So first we see the direct method of horizontal angle. In this method, suppose you have to calculate the angle, horizontal angle AOP. See this figure. So initially you have to set the theodolite over station O. So set up the theodolite at station point O and level it accurately. After the setting the theodolite over station O, you have to done the temporary adjustments, means centering and leveling that instrument. After that, set the vernier A to the 0 or 360 degree of the horizontal circle, and after that tight the upper clamp so that the reading does not change. After that, the loose the lower clamp and turn the instrument and direct the instrument telescope towards the ranging rod at A, and to bisect it accurately with the use of tangent screws. So by using the horizontal tangent screws, bisect the ranging rod at A, and after bisecting accurately, check the reading which must remains 0. After that, read the vernier B and record both the initial readings after bisecting the ranging rod at A. After that, loosen the upper clamp and turn the telescope clockwise until the line of sight bisects the ranging rod at point B on the right hand side, then tight the upper clamp and bisect that point B by turning bisect that point B accurately by turning its tangent screw, means by using that horizontal tangent screws, bisect the ranging rod at point B accurately. After that, read both the verniers, means vernier A and vernier B. The reading of vernier A, which was initially set at 0, gives the value of angle AOB directly. Okay, and that of the other vernier B by deducting 180 degree. So the mean of two vernier readings will give the value of required horizontal angle AOB. In this way, the horizontal angles are measured directly for the ordinary work. So this is the horizontal angle procedure for horizontal angle measurement using direct method. Second method is repetition method. So this is one of the most accurate method for the measurement of horizontal angles. This method is used for very accurate work. In this method, the same angle is added several times mechanically, and correct value of angle is obtained by dividing the accumulated reading by the number of repetitions. The number of repetitions made usually in this method is 6, means 3. 3 number of repetitions with face left position and 3 number of repetitions with face right position. In this way, the angles can be measured to a finer degree of accuracy than that of obtainable with the least count of the vernier. Next is the procedure to determine the horizontal angle by using repetition method. So suppose you have to determine the angle AOB by using repetition method. First calculate the horizontal angle AOB by using direct method. So by adopting the procedure for horizontal angle measurement using direct method, you can calculate the first face left by taking the first face left position, calculate the horizontal angle AOB, and this procedure must be followed for next two readings. So see the procedure here. Initially set up the theodolite at the starting point O and level it accurately. So after fixing and setting the transit theodolite over the station over the starting point O, level that instrument and centered. After that, measure that horizontal angle AOB by using direct method or by following the horizontal angle measurement using direct method. After that, loose the lower clamp and turn the telescope clockwise until the object at A is sighted again. So until that ranging rod at A station is sighted, turn the telescope of transit theodolite in clockwise direction and bisect the point B accurately by using the upper tangent screw. And the verniers will now read the twice the value of angle now. So repeat this procedure for 2 times with face left and with face right. The average of face left reading and average of face right readings are averaged to get a very accurate value of final required angle, horizontal angle AOB. Next point is the errors which are eliminated by method of repetition. So following are the errors which are eliminated by adopting the method of repetition in horizontal angle measurement. So first one is the errors due to eccentricity of verniers and centers are eliminated by taking both the vernier readings and averaging the readings. Second one is the errors due to imperfect adjustment of line of collimation and Trunnion axis of the telescope are eliminated. Okay, So the errors due to imperfect adjustment of line of sight as well as horizontal axis of telescope. Trunnion means horizontal axis of the telescope. These errors are eliminated by adopting the face left and face right observations. Third error means the errors due to inaccurate graduations are minimized by taking the readings on different parts of circle. Okay, so by taking the readings on different parts, the error due to inaccurate graduations must be reduced, it may be reduced or minimized. And next is the errors due to inaccurate bisecting tend to compensate each other. Thank you. Hope all of you understand this video. Thank you.